Hi guys, so today I want to share another story with you. Today I want to talk about Joe Giudice, officially deported and divorced from Teresa after 20 years of marriage. Okay guys, it must really suck to be Joe Giudice. I wouldn't want to be in his shoes if you paid me $1 million. So it's official. He is officially being deported. His final appeal was denied today, and the judge's exact words were, "His appeal is denied on the grounds that he committed a felony which holds as the highest level crime in the U.S. Under federal law, an aggravated felony is considered to be any loss to a victim which exceeds $10,000. And we all know he was way over the limit, $5 million at the very least. So he will be deported. Now, we all know that he's been depressed. It's been reported that he's been depressed the last several months. I mean, he's really taking it hard. They said that he prayed before he went into the hearing. But you know what? I guess it just wasn't meant to be. Now, we know on top of that, he's going to get divorce papers. Teresa has made it no secret. She plans to divorce him after 20 years of marriage. I guess the final straw was getting deported. She doesn't want to take her children and uproot them to a place that is foreign to them. And I'm sure that's very hard on him, you know, losing a 20-year marriage. But what is he facing now that he's been deported? Okay, he's supposed to go back to a town which he has distant relatives, and the name of the town is called Sala Consalina. Now, this town is actually the opposite of his lifestyle here in the United States. It's a rural town. They have no designer boutiques, no nail bars for you to get your nails done. Oh, and most of the house have stalls for livestock. When I say rural people, it's rural. However, Teresa's father has a home there. It was a home that he had before he came to the United States, but it's nothing near what they lived in the U.S. You know, $5 million mansion, this little, you know, mountainside home, okay? And it almost reminds me of an apartment, but they say it's a home. Now, the rumor is his family there, the distant cousins, are going to welcome him with open arms, but none of them speak any English. This is going to be difficult, people. They're also saying that Teresa tried to get him a job through her friends that have mob connections with a guy that was in the mob here. He got committed a felony. I think his was over $75 million, and then he got deported. His name is mobster Tonino Solomon. But I'm not so sure I would go getting help from Tonino, Joe. You don't need any more trouble. The last thing you need to do is go look up your old mob buddy. I mean, that's just my opinion. I mean, what if the job that he wants to give you is being the trigger man or something crazy like that? I don't know, Joe. You gotta lay low. Now, even though Joe seems to be down in the dumps about this new life of his, a lot of people here are saying he committed a crime. He needs to get deported. Even with people saying things like that, I still kind of feel sorry for the children, especially Melania. She's my favorite. And, you know, she's not going to be as close to her father anymore or see him at least on a daily basis. They might still be close, but, you know, it's going to be a different life for everyone involved. However, it seems like Teresa is totally prepared for her new life because, you know, we've been seeing her all over the blogs with her new boyfriend, you know, that she said was just a friend. But, you know, we're not dumb, Teresa. So what I want to know today in my comment section is who feels sorry for Joe and who doesn't. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that notification button for more stories like these. Until next time, talk to you then. Bye.